I have changed B value. Okay. But I can't remember.
Yeah.
What's the value of C?
Something like
that. Ah, yes, I remember this. Sorry? So I change B. I don't know. Maybe. And if now I evaluate C. C, I've changed to?
Yeah.
It's incredible. Why? Because C, as I said before, is a function. And if it's a function, it will be evaluated each time you call it. So each time you call it, it will do the calculation between A plus B. Or you change B if you change B. That is, you change also the definition of C. It's not normal.
What way is A?
A, it's always 5. It's always equal to 5, because it's a value.
B equal A plus B, so why do you enter value of B, C is equal to B?
No, C is not a problem, because C, here, B is equal to 10, okay? And C is equal to A plus B. And if I change, if I can change B, here, B equal to whatever you want, and I want to know the C value. The value of C I've changed because I've changed B because I use variable. And this is awful to trust problem when you have this. So please avoid using variables in your programs. This is the heavy part of computer science. Another big part of computer science is the null pointer exception. And I will say some words about this later on. Okay? Just simple for now? We always like to print something, so just quite a few examples of how we print. And in Scala, we have many ways to print something. Print variable A 2 points, comma A, it will print that way. Not so good. Print variable B 2 points plus B. To print the variable B plus the value of B, because here Scala have guessed that you want the string representation of B, because you put it in a string, you add it to a string. So B has to be a string, and it automatically call the toString method to generate the good representation to the string, and then add it. If you want, you can have an interpolated string, that is variable C, bracket C, and it will also do the same thing. It will call a toString method, but the advantage of this between this that if you have to change it for international reason, sometimes you have to put the word before the variable, sometimes you have to put the variable before the word, and if you have to do this in an international way, this is a better solution, because in your string you see the way where the variable, or in this, you can't change. If you change this, it will never change this. If you change this, it will be here. Okay? You see what I mean?
No.
No?
No. Yes, no.
So when you want to when you want to have a program that runs in many countries, we have many languages. And if we have many languages, we have many ways to write something. Maybe sometimes this way is good for English people. But maybe sometimes it's not good for me. Maybe for French people, I prefer to do this way. So this can be extracted in one file and have a direct correspondence with a translation in French or in English or in Vietnamese or Italian. I don't know the way to write number in countries, but if you extract this one and have the translation of this one, your print will follow the rule. Because here you can extract only variable B. You can extract where you want to put variable B. Here I say where I want to put variables. Okay? You see what I mean? No?
What is the S?
Yeah.
The S, the meaning of S is to interpret this as a evaluation of the variable, your value or definition or whatever.
And if there were two B and C, for example, if there were two S?
No, what S? What S and S? So you can change, is it the translation? So another way to print this multi-lab printer is very useful because I'm sure you have done that. It's a very hard to have a good presentation when you have a multi-line presentation because you have to care about the tabulation of the value, about the character, and so on. And there is a way to do it. Three emails.
Double quote?
Well, double quote, yes, maybe. Three double quotes, and you write as you want, and you end with three double quotes. If you put like this, this will respect the form. So here I have several spaces, here several spaces. But if you put a pipe, this will print in the beginning of the line. And you see, this is a multi-line difference. And you don't have to care about the faces before. But this is not really important in Scala, but it's important to you when you want to print something. Another thing that will result. So type in Scala. There are many types in Scala. In fact, there are approximately 46 types in Scala. Basics type, we can define many other types, but in basics we have 46 types different in Scala. But the main type we use is byte. A byte. Short is the short int, an int with, I think it's. 16 bit int, 32 bit long, 64 bit. So you can put longer and higher value. Double and close for the plot value, the decimal value, char for characters, strings for strings, boolean for a boolean, I misspelled it.
And string itself, not the really strings?
I don't think that. And three types, which is basic type, and you never noticed them before.
Yes.
Unit, nothing, and any. Yes. But these three types is really important. Unit is something that don't produce result. Because in Scala, everything has a value. And can you tell me the value of this print? A print has the value. Yes? So the type of this expression is unit. For the C-man, C-sharp, in Java, maybe it's quite to void. Nothing. But nothing. It's unit. Unit. No result, no value for the result. It's referred to something that you process and have a board effect. Like println. Println is the next feature and has to a board effect to print something on the screen, but with no value. Nothing, my favorite type. Nothing means nothing. Not null. You know null value extension? When you check some object in oriented object, and you check, and the compiler says, oh no, null pointer exception. So I won't continue. What? Why? No. Say nothing. Because nothing says I don't. No, I know that I have a value, but for now, we have nothing stored in it. I don't not store a value that is absurd. I say, no, nothing, there is no value for now. It's very different to say null, because null is a value. Nothing is a type. And nothing refers to the way to say, I know for now I can't produce a result. Maybe I will have in the future. For now, you have nothing in this value. Yeah.
It is similar to mount or mint. Nothing is similar to mount, value
or mint. Yes, similar to mount, but. But new, we should avoid using it because you all have seen when you write programs, everybody have encounter a null pointer exception. If you say that in a processing, you can have a value or not, use nothing when you have no value for the processing. The processing have failed. Nothing. The processing have correctly run. Okay, got the value. No problem. But if you have no value, why you should produce a value, a stupid dumb value? No. Say, I have nothing to say. Be proud to say, I have nothing. Last one, any. It represents any type. It's a mother class of all the types. I won't spend too much time in this, but any is say I can have any type there. So I can define type variable where AI in the 2 points int equal 5. Here I specify the type. I say A is the type of int. If I do not specify it like I did it before, Scala will choose the appropriate type. So if I want to have a double, I need to put double. AD, 2. Double equal 5. I need to put it double. It will be a double in the type. But 5 as an int is not the same as 5 as a double. And you can define the Boolean. I put it because for the word true or false in the lower case. And if you use a bad type, Scala complains. It complains. You say place is an int and you enter a string, Scala directly complains. So this is the advantage of statically typed system, because before you can run your program, before, just at compilation, Scala says no, this is not possible. I won't let you use this. And it's failed. And you have to correct. Here it's a very simple example. But imagine that this is a remote processing. The remote processing have to type this, the return value. And when you use the declaration, it checks that the type that you put here is the same type as the remote processing return. If not the same time, he says no, you have a problem of type. Check it. So when in programming you avoid null pointer exception, you avoid type exception, you're quite close to the answer. It's okay for everybody? Yes? Expression. In Scala, everything is expression. An expression is, for example, val. This is a simple expression. Print is also an expression. And every expression has a value. But we can also have a complex definition of a value. Here I put a value, a bracket, a complex definition, still centimeter per inch equal 2.54. And EC is, for example, 15 for times centimeter per inch. I can do even what I want here. I don't want to have a complex example, just to avoid just to avoid to calculate something, just to avoid to put the definition. But in the value, you can put complex processing here. And this is one expression. Even if I put val EU equal println EA, like I said before, this has a value of type unique. Because it's not out of value. And the result is, I should run it. I should run it. And you see that everything, has been calculated, the centimeter per inch has been calculated, and rather the good value, I think. I hope. So the calculation is done. And when you have this, this is value. So you don't have, you can't change it after. If you need to change it, recompute it. Okay? and notice even printed have recipe. You need, but this doesn't. Go back. Yes, I can go. Because it's here, it's not the real environment of color in the temperature, so it always say what you have done. Okay, the real things, the real part is this, but the spark notebook says what you have in memory, possibly. But it's not printed by the print system here. So, we do not have so much time, so you can do the exercise just a little later. The if statement is also an expression, and it's very powerful. You can have if, you know, always, everyone knows what is a if. Yes? What is, how to use it? I think. If A square to 0, greater than, okay, positive number, else printed as negative number. You can omit the else if you don't have it, if you do not have else part. Still, if A modulo 2 equals 0, printed an even number. But if I don't want to print an that is an odd number, I do not need to. And you can omit also the bracket if there is also one, if there is only one expression underneath. So this one is equivalent to this one. Okay? But the thing is that it is really amusing. Yes, we can use it. Because I can say that if A equals you remember, this is a simple expression. And in Scala, everything is expression. And every expression has a value. And this statement, if A modulo 2 equals 0, 0 x 1 have a value depending on the value of what of A. And here, total has a value of 0. It's very powerful notation because remember in your old computer language, you have to do if A modulo B equals 0, toto equals 0, S toto equals 1. And doing this, it's more difficult to check error. Because toto can be assigned by two way different ways. Here, toto is assigned by one different way.
And you cannot write toto equals A modulo 2?
You can also? Yes, I can. But just to, for example, I can.
Toto equals A modulo 2 égal equal equal 0.
Yes.
You can write everything you want that is an expression here. And in scalar, everything is an expression. So you can write everything you want here. It will be always evaluated. Yes? Okay? Okay for everybody?
If you want to change the type, previously you double. You can do that with all the type to char to.
No. 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 If you say here val toto string, he says no. This is not a string. If you want this to be a string, you have to use the correct method. Maybe. Maybe finally I don't know if it's not, yes.
Okay, to string.
You have to say. Because Scala wants you to know what you are doing. If you say A modulo 2 equals 0, Scala knows that it's a Boolean. If you want a string, here, you, because of the type you choose, you have to use the correct method. You will see later on that Scala can use automatic translation, but I don't like it. Okay? So, let's start to be concrete and to define processes. Here I define a method. A method like a mini program that will specific the specific process. Okay? Here I know the min function exists in Scala. I know it. But here I define the min functions. Okay? So here def min, that means I define a function with two parameters of type int and int, which I name later on x and y. That returns an int. So I know min have two parameters of type int and returns an int.
Okay. You have to precise the type of the int and the output. It's a good way to do
it. No, you will see no reason why. But you have already to precise the input type. So Scala can check if you call the good method. So you have always to precise the type. If x lesser than y, then x is y. This will tell you the good value of minimum. But Scala is a statically tip system, but it can infer it easily. And here, as x and y are int, he knows that the return type will be int. So you can commit this. But look, here, the two methods are exactly the same limitation. So in the first one, the definition of min, you precise all the thing. You say my first input is an int, my second input is an int, and this response is an int. And in the second method that you didn't define the response method is an int, Scala, as it knows that x and y are int, knows that the response will be an int. Okay? So Scala can infer the type you have. So you can omit this offer. And notice this. This is exactly the same thing. But I remove the square because this is a single expression. One expression. So I do not need the square. Here, x and y are also single expression. So I can remove also the square. And notice that in this, you do not have the dot comma separator. You know this, this stupid error when you're programming and you put point comma everywhere and sometimes you forget it. And you compare and the compiler said, oh, I was expecting a point, point comma, but I didn't find it. Why didn't you put it? Okay? Here, I don't have to bother with this stupid sign. New line is enough.
So, how to say, can we change the value of x or y in the function? In the function, the value of x?
No.
Can we
change? No, you can't do this.
Because
these are values.
Values, okay. So it's a depend on my declaration. It's a depend, the trend of variables depends on my definition.
Yes.
On values or variables.
No, it doesn't depend on the definition of x and y. Here, you do not have choice. It's value. You never modify your input. You do not need to modify your input. Because if you modify your input, that means that your function will not produce the same result if you call it twice. And this is not good. If you have to send back a response with a modified input, you send it in the response. But do not modify input. It's very difficult to check errors and to find bugs when you modify your inputs. So I encourage you to never modify your inputs. Produce complex results if you want, but do not modify your inputs. And keep in mind that this language will be executed on many computers. So if you modify your inputs, how you can trust the modification on every computer? The state of the global system will not be safe. So please do not modify. Scala won't let you go, but do not modify your inputs, even when you are programming in other language. Never. The Boolean, I don't know if you were familiar with this, but it's the same notation that we see in Java and many languages. Double ampersand means end. And double pipe means force. Okay, this is the same thing. End and or. And in Scala, there is an interesting feature that means that you can use both of notation. BB space double ampersand space force is equivalent to BB point AA parenthesis force parenthesis. That means when you do this, you apply the function ampersand with a parameter force on this value. This is the same thing. So every function that you can write in this way, you can write in this way. And this talks to computer science. This was not to mathematician. Because here it's an operator. So if it's it's an operator, use it as an operator. Do not use as it a function. Except if you are a computer science. It's more easy to read this than this. No? It's more clear. So if it's more clear, use it. And every function that you can write like that can be right on that. To define a function, a dumb function that takes x parameters, that is a boolean, wait a few times, and return x. We can imagine here some complex processing, but here I don't need to have complex processing. Just here, I want my function to wait. And returning back to the same value. So when I run this, so I just think I should run this before. And yes, so so I define this function, and when I execute this one, it takes time and we're doing the same result as expected. Okay? Imagine you have a complex processing here. I don't know why, but here I just want to wait to simulate this complex processing. And if I define a function and s that takes 200 and do the n, that is not a function. So these do exactly the same than the amp function. Now, what would be the result of this? Check it. And you notice that, of course, the result is good because this is a good function. Do the job. But you have noticed that the result has been very long because of this type, this code, which is a complex processing. Okay? Which is normal. Yes? Everybody understand? So I have an end function that's called the system end function. And here in my parameters, I simulate the complex processing. But sometimes, when n is false, false n, as we see, will be always false. Okay? Maybe I shouldn't have wait here. Because I already know the result with the first parameters. And false, I do not care of this process. Because I know that the result will be false. And if I run this, you have noticed that this is wrong. And if I run this, the system call, you will notice that this is not the same thing. It responds directly false, without calling this thing. But if Scala can do it, we can also define it in a function. In fact, when you evaluate a function, there is two ways of evaluating. You can evaluate first parameters, that is not called by values. So before calling the function ns, I have to evaluate all the parameters and then call the processing. This is called by value. But I maybe I can also repress this call with this argument and do the processing. This is called backend. So rather than evaluate the parameter, I will evaluate first the function and use this definition. And when I need it, I will evaluate the parameters. This is called binding. And Scala allows us to say how we evaluate the parameters. Did I have to evaluate by value, like this, or by name, like this? Notice this symbol equal return. And this is evaluation by value, evaluation by name. And if you know this, it will be faster. Because here I have exactly the same functionality that the good one is here. As the same thing that the system value, the system call. Because here, I know it could be a long process, but if this process has no interest due to the first parameter, does I have to call it? Imagine here, it's a web service consuming time and money. Did I have to waste money and time because I don't know how to program? Just say, I know that it could be irrelevant to evaluate the system because with this system it could be sufficient to take a decision. So if you can take a decision with one parameter, the other one should be evaluated by name. And this is a way to be more efficient. And you have seen the result of it is faster than the result before. Yes?
Why we don't always use the evaluation by name?
Because sometimes the evaluation by name is longer. Because if you have...
If you have directly the result of the Boolean, why it should be longer?
Because if in the processing you have three times wipe, you will evaluate it three times. So sometimes longer. And a word about recursivity. You know recursivity? What is recursivity? What recursivity is a function that calls itself. Very simple. In very simple to say. Maybe quite difficult to manage, but very simple to say. Here I have a definition of recursive function. You notice that it's a recursive function because sum is the method here, the name of the method, and in the name of the method, I have a call to the same function. Okay. Here, I have sum x of type int, returning a type int, and here, the type int, the return type is necessary, mandatory. You have to, and if you don't, Scala complain. Again, he complains a lot at the compilation time. Once you have passed the compilation time, he never complains. If x equals 0, I return 0, else I do the x plus sum of x minus 1. Here I am doing the sum of the x first number of integral number. So if I put sum of 5, it will work. Because it will compute. Sum of 5 is 5 plus sum of 4. Sum of 4 is 4 plus sum of 3. So it's 5 plus 4 plus 3 plus 2 plus 1 plus 0. I know I can stop at 1, but first stop at 0. And 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 equals to 15. Okay? And this is what we learned. But what happens if I put here minus 5? I can't use minus 5 because here I test if x equals to 0 and I decrease always x. So I start at a negative number and I omit 1 each time. There is no chance that x will become equal to 0. And on the graph here, we have a stack overflow because we can't process anymore anytime because Java and Scala have done some minus 5, minus 6, 7, etc. In the end of the night, they have crashed. And in Scala, we can avoid this. We can put a requirement to call this function. I require x to be greater than 0. If not, I will put this number. And the processing is exactly the same. So when I do sum of 5, it processes the same result. And if I don't put sum of 5, but I put sum of 2, sum of minus 1, Scala says requirement failed. You should have put number positive number. What I said, what I was. So you know that you have a requirement failed. And later on you can process this. Domain definition approach. Like your sense. I think you already know the domain definition function. Why don't you put this in code? In mathematics, you never use a function that is not defined.
My students.
Your students, yes. But the logical ones. Never use. So in computer science, we should have this availability, opportunities to express this. Okay? Yes. Last thing. One more thing. If I don't put the return number of a recursive function, it's a recursive method. So needs result type. Because to know the type of this, he has to know the type of this. 0, it can be the int, the short, the float, the bulk, etc. But x, you know, it's an int. But plus some of this, you don't. So you have to put the return type. You do not have choice. That's the important thing for we can have a recursivity terminal.
Recursivity
much faster than you define a function that will calculate intermediate values. If you want to do the sum of the x first number, you can say that 1, okay, I have 1, and I know I have to do 2 plus something else. So when I check the two numbers, 1 plus 2 is 3, and I keep in mind I have 3, and I have to do 3 plus etc. Okay?
you have an integer result, temporary result. That is prefer to write to write it in math mode. Sorry. That is to say that if I have some, it is equal to 1 plus some from a equal to 20. Okay? This is a partial result of the sum. And this is what we are doing here. I say, my sum can start with a number, and I will do the rest of the your putting. And this process exactly the same thing. But notice that here, I use tag-like an annotation that allows Scala to be much faster than the other way to write. Because this can be done in parallel. And if I can be parallel here, I have to replace this. And then Scala will run faster. And just to explain, I define a global function, some RTG, which check an X, because I want just to put some X. But me, as a computer science, I don't want this, I want to use my function, my recursive terminal function. So I define in this function another function, which is here, and then I call it with the first value, that is zero, the null operator, the neutral element of the operation. And then, here I have defined it, and when I call it, it will evaluate this, do the requirement, and compute the sum, and return the result. Very efficient tool. Yes? Yes. With 15, with 5 numbers, you don't know this for the result, but put a big number, you will see the result. But if you put a number, you should not put an it. You should not use an it, use big it. And I think it's time to Avalanche. So if you have any question, I can answer, and then search later. We will start again later. Okay, see you.